With this note, let me introduce our chairperson of the day, Ms. Guncha Mittal, Head of Customer Success at Force. With 17 years of diverse experience, Ms. Mittal excels in learning and development, training management, recruitment, and business strategizing. Adept at client relations, infrastructure setup, content creation, and technical roles, she is dedicated, adaptable, and a strong people manager. So let's welcome Ms. Guncha Mittal with a huge round of applause.
Thank you, Naveen. Hi, everybody. Good morning. I know it's going to be a series of good mornings for a couple of more hours, so please bear with us. Well, he introduced me already. My name is Guncha, and I'm representing EdForce here. EdForce is the presenting partner of today's event. First of all, I'm really grateful that you all are here today, and sorry for the big goof up about the breakfast. I assure you I'm going to talk to the concerned teams after my talk. I really apologize for that. Let me quickly begin with a few statistics here. Is my voice clear and audible? All right. So according to LinkedIn's workplace learning report, 94% of the employees feel that they would stay longer in the organization if their L&D teams invested in their learning and growth. Yet there is another staggering report from Gallup. This is an old report where only 13% of the employees are strongly agreeing to the fantastic work, the excellent work that the L&D teams are doing while onboarding the new employees. I just want to say here that you should notice a striking gap that is, expected by an employee in the organization, whereas what is being delivered by the L&D team here. The numbers have gone up to 27% by the latest report of 2024, which shows even that is fantastic work that the teams are doing, but I think the show and the work must go on. There was another report by India Today and LinkedIn News that the latest Gen Z, 67% of the job seekers, feel that they should prioritize their learning and growth over salary packages. Have you all seen this report? Has anybody seen this 2024 Learning Workplace report? Or could you just raise your hands, please, if anybody has seen it? Thank you. When I was speaking at the last conference, there were no hands raised because I think the report had just come out. It's pretty latest. So I would recommend everybody, all of you, to just go through the report. It's just available on the LinkedIn. I want to share and showcase the top 10 focus areas of the 2024 as displayed by this report itself. Aligning the learning programs to an individual's needs is the top focus area for the second time in a row. Obviously, upskilling and creating a culture of learning is the base. And I want to show you here that there is an item which is demanding attention, which is to help the employees grow in their careers. This has gone from number 9 to number 4 this year. So this clearly demands attention. Improving employee retention has always been on this list. These were the top 5. Do you think you could guess what the next 5 focus areas could be? Any suggestions, any guesses? Take a guess. Yes, it's very hot in the market, that's right. Sorry? Automation. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, I think we are still, lagging a little behind. None of those make to the top 10 areas. We are still hitting the base here, supporting an employee through an organization change whenever they are switching jobs, improving learner engagements, and measuring the success of their learning programs. Ensuring diversity, equity, inclusion has always been on this list, considering the fairness to every religion, caste, creed, gender, etc. There's a new entry here this time in this list, which is promoting the employees' well-being. The report says that the employees who feel that they are heard in their organization, their voices are heard, they are likely to perform nearly 5 times better in their work. Now, some best practices and factors to show you to have a successful L&D leadership. The first one is leading with empathy, which means to create an environment where people feel at ease. 87% of the organization CEOs feel that the financial performance of an organization is tied up with the empathy at work. Embracing change, we should encourage all our employees to, you know, embrace change in this constant world of innovation and changes. This is also the agenda of today's conference, where they want to talk about embracing change in this hybrid environment. Next on the list is acting as a mentor, because when you act as a mentor, you grow with others. Everybody grows with you. Welcome different views, because we don't know who has what kind of ideas and insights and experiences. The last one is very interesting, which says that you should... that you should be hiring age-diverse people. They say that across generations, you could have some wonderful insights, experiences, etc. So there should be no gap there. From young to old to not so young, everybody should be given an equal chance. Just give me a second, guys. Yeah. Thank you. Now that we have seen these wonderful insights today, let me welcome you all formally to today's 6th L&D Confex Awards happening here in Namma, Bengaluru. Please use today's event to learn about the latest trends, best practices, innovations, ideas in the L&D industry. Use it as a platform for networking and talking to like-minded people. Share your own experiences, gain some insights, learn about some solutions that the L&D industry is offering. Having said that, I would like to leave you all with a wonderful note here, that capacity to learn is a gift, ability to learn is a skill, and willingness to learn is a choice. And I'm really delighted that you all made this choice today to take some learning home. That's it today. This was my time. I thank the GainSkills team to bring me here on the dais today. And once again, we apologize for the breakfast goof up. The EdForce team, the GainSkills team, is going to be on the floor to listen to your inputs, any feedback that you have. And that's it. Thank you and have a wonderful day ahead.
Please be on the stage, Ms. Guncha Mittal. Thanks a lot for delivering the chairperson's remark. To do the felicitation, I would like to request Mr. Kabir Aswani, Vice President of Learning and Development at Moody's Corporation, to please join us on the dais.